All right, so good afternoon, everyone. My name is Yang Wang, and I am Associate Professor in Civil Environmental Engineering. I hold adjunct position in our Electrical and Computer Engineering. So I'm a structural engineer by training, and I found a second home, academic home, in electrical engineering. And my research focuses on the sustainability of our civil structures, buildings, bridges, dams, tunnels, et cetera, with the emphasis of leveraging advanced electronic sensing technologies. In the United States, the ASCE, that's the American Society of Civil Engineers, gave a report card for the nation's infrastructure once every couple of years. So they give A, B, C, D for each type of infrastructure, just like student GPA. For example, in the most recent report card, the nation's dams are rated as D, which is, of course, far worse than our student GPA here at Tech. And our bridges normally are rated around C, C minor, sometimes C plus, a little better, but still it's lower than the good condition, which entails a B grade. So why is that? Because we are an industrialized nation, and most of our infrastructure was constructed decades ago. Taking bridges, for example, about one third of the bridges in this country, they were constructed more than 50 years ago. And 50 years normally is the design life of a civil structure. So they're operating beyond their design life. Some of them may be operating beyond 100 years, if not more. So as the infrastructure ages, their sustainability is becoming a looming concern in industrialized nations. There is not sufficient funds to retrofit or to repair all those bridges to bring them up to a good B conditions. So we need to prioritize our resources so that they are used most efficiently on those most demanding structures. And as I often say to my students in structural analysis or structural dynamics classes, our generation of civil structural engineers is much more fortunate than our previous generations. Why is that? Because over the past few decades, electronics and computing have rapidly evolved. Our previous generations designing a structure, and the structure just sits there for decades. And the most often inspection we do is visual inspection. We don't have nearly enough quantified sensor data. But our generation has the luxury of installing more and more sensors on those. Those are important and very expensive investment of a human society, buildings, bridges, et cetera. So we are having the ability to be able to instrument much more of our structures with more and more sensors so that we can better prioritize our limited resources for bridge retrofitting. And my research group develops low-cost wireless sensing devices for civil structures. They are wireless so that you don't need to run long cables, for example, in a long span bridge. So they are much more convenient and lower cost to install, and we will be able to, in the future, collect more and more data from those structures, learn about more and more about what really happens for those large-scale civil structures that are just standing out there in the wild. And we have a showcase poster here about our Georgia DOT research project on bridge weight motions. I'll talk about this project for a couple more minutes. So it's called bridge weight motion. The objective is to capture overloaded trucks. As those trucks drive on our road surface, their overloading can cause significant damage to the pavement, if not to the bridge structures themselves. There are indeed weigh stations along the interstate highways. However, most truck drivers would be able to find local routes to bypass the state routes to bypass. And there are so many state routes. So we're the GOT, the Georgia DOT is interested in finding low-cost sensing solutions to this problem. So we propose to develop bridge sensors that are mounted on the bridge. And we measure the response of the bridge and try to use this bridge response to back derive the weight of the trucks. So this is as if using the bridge at the scale, heavier trucks would make the scale move more, right? So it sounds like a simple idea, but if you put more thoughts into it, it's actually not simple. First of all, scales are good for measuring static weight. I cannot ask the truck to go to the bridge and stop there after wait and let it drive on. So we can't stop the traffic. So all the data is dynamic as the truck is roaring through the bridge. And second, one heavy truck may have the same weight as multiple lighter trucks. How do you distinguish that? Cameras may be helpful, but still, in order to quantify the weight of the truck, we need sensor vibration data such as the strain or accelerations from the bridge. So this is called an inverse problem. We measure the dynamic response of a structural system. We try to use the response to back derive the dynamic load on the system. And I will not get into a lot of the details. We take a two-step approach. First step is to, we found that in order to do this back derivation wall, in order to solve this inverse problem wall, we have to have a good, accurate model of the bridge first. So if needed, we temporarily close the traffic. We have sensors on the bridge. We do shaker testing on the bridge deck, get all the girder vibrations, use all this field measured vibration properties to calibrate our computer model of the bridge. And after we have a more accurate model, we then develop this so-called input estimation algorithm. That is, we again use the response, dynamic response of the bridge. We try to back derive the load input, the dynamic truck load on this bridge. So long story short, we have a Georgia DOT showcase project on the sustainability of civil infrastructure using low-cost wireless sensors to monitor and operating loads. And also, since we have the sensors on the bridge already, they can help to not just estimate the truck weight, they can also help to monitor the bridge behavior, monitor the bridge performance. Any anomaly may be warning signs of the bridge deterioration over time. So please feel free to stop by our poster as titled Wireless Sensing and Bridgeway in Motion, and I'll be happy to get into any of the more details if you're interested. Thank you.